for the ride of a lifetime with the Switch.
You can buy it, you can poop and put it on your vegetable garden.
All right, it is time for another Switch. It is Thursday, the 7th of July 2016. You know, by now I just realized that at the time of this broadcast, I will probably be happily playing my new bass by now, by then.
Yeah, and I'll be in El Paso.
No, on the 7th?
On the 8th, I'll be there.
Yeah, so you're not here yet.
No, nope, I'll be there on the 8th.
Are you going to be here for the show on the 8th? You will, huh?
Depending on the traffic.
Yeah.
Remember, it takes 12 hours to drive from Houston to El Paso.
Yeah, it depends. It really depends what time you start out.
Yeah, I'm gonna try to start out at 3 o'clock in the morning.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so you should be here around 2 or 3.
Yeah, hopefully.
Four,
if going, if traffic goes okay.
Are you coming straight here?
Oh, yeah, I'm going to go straight I-10.
No, I'm saying you're coming straight to the studio.
Yes.
Okay. And you might have to wake my ass up or something. Hey, get up! I'm coming. I'm here.
I'll stop in. Of course, I'll stop and fill up for gas on the way in.
Surprised you're not gonna try. Oh no, I keep saying I'm surprised you're not gonna stop at Chico's Tacos, but we're gonna do Chico's.
No, we're doing it. We're doing all that stuff together.
Yeah, we're doing Chico's.
Yeah.
Believe me, man. If it was me, the temptation would be hard to resist. It would.
But see, coming in through I-10, there is
you
no
don't even
Chico's
pass
Tacos.
By it. Yeah. Nope. If you pass by it, it'd probably be different.
probably not. No. I would probably say no because I already made the deal that we were gonna go together.
I can't wait. It's gonna be fun. Geekies, man.
Yep. Gussie's Bakery.
Michael Ball, you have to come down to El Paso, and we have to show you some real delicious food, man.
Some
real food. You guys have all the haggis and all that up there, but we have...
good eating.
Yeah, what the hell do we have that the Brits wouldn't know? They know what tacos are, obviously.
Yeah, but they get tacos that are probably frozen more than likely up there.
There you go, Ball. That's a question for you, which you're probably not going to answer until, like, the 8th of July. Well, who knows what we'll be recording for on the 8th of July. We'll get an answer, like, 2 weeks from now.
Yeah, no shit.
So, stick around for the taco discussion up in Michael Ball. I'm curious. I want to know.
Because remember, he said they had nachos, but they were frozen, remember?
Yeah. No, I don't.
I could have sworn he said they were frozen or they came in a box.
I don't remember that. I don't remember. No.
Yeah, because remember he quoted Old El Paso and he was asking about that?
I remember that.
And then he said it was nachos. So I assume they came in a box.
To me, it sounded like Doritos, like nacho Doritos or something like that. Chips.
Oh,
it sounded
I don't know.
Like chips.
I could have sworn he said something about Old El Paso and Old El Paso makes the nachos in a box.
Yeah, but I think they also make chips.
Yeah, the corn chips, they would call crisp over
I
there.
I think that's what he got from Old El Paso is those chips.
The tortilla chips.
I believe so.
Oh, those are delicious.
Are they? I've never had them from Old El Paso.
Dude, you got to get them because you put them with the salsa.
What kind of salsa? What do you get?
Well, I like the mango habanero.
I like mango habanero. Delicious.
And it has that because you know why? Because it has the sweet.
Where can you get it?
It has the bite. Walmart sells it.
Dude, we gotta go get some. I'm telling you, man. I don't know. My mother just cannot find that stuff for the life of her. Whenever I ask for that stuff,
I can make it too. Buy the jalapenos and the mango.
That too. You could
cut it up, and make it fresh, homemade salsa.
That'll be great. Well, although my teacher, that coach would recommend that I make it, but I'm like, no, I'm not gonna screw it up. Nope.
No, fresh jalapenos. There's a problem with that. Since you can't see, you can't. You might end up getting the stuff on your fingers and then burning your fingers and your eyes and.
Well, that's the thing. So don't wash or don't touch your eyes until you wash your hands and shit.
You know the thing is with jalapenos like that. When you do it, sometimes you have to rinse your fingers with milk.
Milk, yeah, that makes sense. Milk
to get rid of the chili.
Yep.
But anyways, I don't want to linger too much on food.
Why? You hungry or what?
No, I'm just don't want to bore people on the topic.
Hell, I love talking about food. Anyway, I guess I figured we would keep playing more of those say what I say pranks. What do you think? You want to keep
and then we have two science topics coming
and
up.
And we
too.
Have, one per show.
Okay, one per show. Okay, sounds good.
Yeah, I would do one per show. Spread them out a little bit.
Okay, sounds good. Yeah, we have a science topic that we can throw in there.
Yeah.
They're always fun to hear, fun facts.
Of course, we forgot to tell you, of course, but You might figure we might have put him into submission. He's all quiet over there. But no, Michael Ball is not here today, actually, for this show.
What a shame. I thought you finally beat him to death and you got quiet. We cracked the whip on him. He's got a leash. We want him to speak. We pull the leash.
I have to say, after that last episode where I scared him after death with that strange but news.
That was a good one. That was a good one. I gotta admit.
If you haven't heard that, guys, yet, go to the switch.podhoster.com and download that. As a matter of fact, we might even just play the clip. It's just so funny. It is great. That is going to be on the bloopers. Do I still have it up here?
Yes. Oh, try it and see.
Nope, I sure don't. But I can in a minute.
Nope.
I can have it up in a minute. Just because it was classic. July, no. It was the 6th, right? Yeah.
Yes, I think it was.
That's when it happened.
Yeah.
Oh, I do believe that is when it happened here. We'll just, matter of fact, let's play this.
We gotta get started first.
Yeah, let's play this track real quick. This Polytones, and we'll be back.
That's what we call dancing. Prospects drive us,
this dancing. The Polytones, we call this dancing. Mr. Guy Williams here. Hello there, guy.
Hello, Governor.
Hello, Governor.
That's my shitty impression of trying to be a wannabe Brit.
Ah, that's all right.
I gave up a long time ago. I ain't gonna continue. It's not worth it. I'll just stick to being me. I give up. Oh, well.
You tried to be a Brit.
I tried. It didn't work. Nope. Couldn't master it.
Shame.
Shame. Yeah, it's a shame. It's a pity. But it's okay. That's why we're over here and they're over there.
Exactly.
But that was a good track. The Polytones, I always love those guys.
Me too. I want to recap on this moment from yesterday, yeah. When Michael, I totally scared Michael Ball out of his balls. I mean, his hair, his ball, his pubic hair literally just receded. It receded, yeah. When I did this. Okay.
Soda.
All right. Are you ready? Just kidding. Just kidding. I thought I'd get.
But no, I've got nothing here but a voice broken job. I'm thinking now, and I sound like a 2-year-old. You kids. I can't believe you just did that to me. I was like, oh my god.
That's funny.
I thought that would give you a little bit of a fright.
Good. That was a good one. I deserved that. That was good. Oh, my voice went as high as anything. Practically shattered the windows in my bloody... Oh, I was scrolling. Oh, I'm going to find one. Luckily I had the page up.
All I gotta say about that one is, if it shattered his windows, he's got some pretty shitty windows.
I gotta tell you though, man, that was a lot of fun. I enjoyed that. And like I said, did I say it on air or off air? I forgot now.
I don't remember now.
But you and him owe me one good one, and I still owe you one. I already got him.
Yeah.
I don't know what the hell I'm gonna do for you yet, but.
I don't know.
It might happen a year from now. Who knows?
Who knows? Yeah, exactly.
All right. Here's a bit of cell phone tower anger.
Hello, Mr. Brian Birch. It's Jacoby. I'm calling you from the Mnandi Council.
From the?
Mnandi Council, sir.
Yeah.
How are you today, sir?
Oh, thanks.
This is about the construction at 744 Oakmont at Copper Leaf.
Yeah.
When can we come? Because we need to put their tower up.
Tower?
The cell phone tower, yes.
You're putting it up where?
It's there in the backyard of 744.
Yeah.
Your
No, there's no tower going up in my backyard.
Sir, there is. That's why I'm calling you.
Now you can forget. Well, I don't care who or where you call it from, but you can't put one in my backyard, John.
That is the spot that's been identified as the perfect place.
No way! I'm not having a cell phone tower in my property, John.
Sir, this has already been approved. I just need to make a...
They can't approve it. It's a f***ing private property.
Sir, it's not a choice. That's what I'm telling you.
Well, it is a choice because I'm not having radioactive signals in my f***ing backyard. Thank you very much. And I paid a lot of money for that f***ing property, and there's no way I'm accepting a cell phone tower there. But actually, I don't care what you say, mate. You're not putting a f***ing cell phone tower in my property.
Okay, sir, see? I'm not your mate. I'm not your China either, okay?
Ooh. Oh,
well, okay, whatever. I actually don't... You're upsetting me, all right?
I wonder what China... I guess it's like my... I have no idea.
I don't know what that is.
My China.
To me, well, here in the U.S., China is the thing you eat on.
Oh, yeah, it is, isn't it? Well, obviously, there it's a term of... I don't want to say endearment or affection, but like dude or man or...
I guess. I don't know what to
China.
Look it up later.
If we can have somebody come back at us on that one, I'm curious as to how you guys use it out there, what it means specifically, exactly. I guess it's just like dude or something.
Sir, you... Did you drop
cell phone reception?
Wait, he's stuttering for one.
You see, I'm
back.
It's breaking up.
You see, sir, your phone is breaking up that side. That's why you need the cell phone tower. It's breaking up all the time, sir.
No,
it's
no. You phone me back or send me an email with regards to this. There's no way you're putting a cell phone tower in my property, sir.
But sir, I promise you tomorrow we're coming.
Oh, you can come and I'll f***ing take a gun and I'll shoot the eggs.
Yo.
I actually don't f***ing care. You're not coming to my property to put a f***ing cell phone tower in. End of story. I bought the property and there's nothing in terms and conditions in there about a cell phone tower. At all. Hold on a second. I'm not going to
the
my
down.
Actually, you know what, eh? Just go away. You annoy me. Thanks,
sir, wait, hold on.
I don't know. Maybe you're talking to somebody else.
Did you see?
Hello, sir. It's me. Why are you being...
Listen, I'm finding the homeowners now. Just leave me the fuck alone. All right, I don't want to talk to you, buddy. Hello?
Hello, sir. Yes. Why are you being so rude to me, please?
Because you have no authorization to come put a tower in my residential property, right? Only just being finished built, and you think you're going to come put a tower in here? You're not.
It's not your choice.
Well, actually, it is my choice. I own the property, buddy.
Wait.
No, I'm not waiting, okay? I don't need to talk to you. Listen to me. What's your name?
I told you my name's Jacob, sir. I'm losing my patience now.
What's your surname? You're losing your patience. What do you think you are,
Tyler? Sir, I'm trying to have a conversation with you.
No, you're not trying to help or anything. Okay. Just leave me alone.
Sir, listen. As the council will undertake that if you get, after maybe 1 or 2 years, some growths on your body from radiation of the cell phone towers, we've got medical aid that will cover you for that. And just think, you're doing it so your neighbors can get good cell phone signal too. Is do it for the community.
Sir, you're not pulling me there tomorrow, if you do, I'm going to hit whoever arrives with a baseball bat.
You're going to hit with a baseball bat. Well, we'll hit you with a cell phone tower, sir. Okay. We've got a few options, sir.
There's no options.
There's a straight tower. There's one that looks like a palm tree. Sir, you're going to have the best cell phone signal in the whole place. Why are you complaining?
No, I don't give a shit. I don't want a cell phone tower. Radioactive signals in my backyard, thanks.
I believe you've had plans for a pool to go there.
How would you know that?
Because we've looked at the plans. Okay.
I'll prosecute you for illegally entering my property. Yes.
No, sir, that's not possible. Okay. Okay.
So that's actually at the most worst possible day you could phone it. Oh, crumb.
Okay, just hold on there. Hold on. Hello, Mr. Birch.
No, you got the wrong number.
No, sir, I know it's you. Okay, hold on. I got somebody who wants...
How do you know it's me?
Because I know your voice.
You don't know my voice. I've never met you in my life.
Okay, I just want you to talk to somebody. Somebody say hello.
Hello, Jules. How are you?
What's this about?
This is about Whackhead Simpson, Julian.
That's just weird. Like, Whackhead, you're coming out, dude.
George, you told me I got no sense of humour.
To be honest, Julian, the cell phone signal there is not great. I think to have a cell phone down your backyard would be the right thing.
You wound me up, dog. I have a hopstick.
Julian Reinbach.
Would you let them put a cell phone tower in your backyard?
Me? I would for a fee, not for free. I would for $1 million a month.
Well, damn. $1 million a month?
Well, because see, technically, cell phone towers, they pay for commercial rental property, right? For the to put up a tower.
At least
on
here
the
in
property.
The U.S. anyway.
And they pay through the nose for rental for that space.
Like I say, at least here in the U.S. Who knows how it is in South Africa?
Yeah, I don't know about South Africa, but I know here in the U.S. it's commercial property rental fees. And they could be anywhere from $100,000 to $1 million a month.
I believe it. So you would charge $1 million.
Because I know down here from where the Walmart is, by my apartment complex, they have a T-Mobile tower.
Uh-huh.
And T-Mobile's paying Walmart $500,000 a month.
Wow.
Rental for that space.
Wow, that's crazy.
Yeah, well, that's what makes the world go around. Well, anyways, this area, anyways.
Money.
947 Anita, Sajemko speaking.
Okay, so he's calling his own receptionist, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Keep that in mind.
Okay.
How's it? Darren here, how are you?
Yes, how can I help you?
Okay. Listen, Jacob.
Hey, I've never heard Darren on the phone before.
I just gave me a call. Yeah, right. A lot of people were requesting a song that I played this morning on the show.
Well, yes, we have.
Oh, it was our Darren.
When?
We have too. When he was calling from the police station.
Oh yeah, that's right.
When he got arrested.
Yeah, it just sounds different. He sounds different. Sounds
yeah,
weird.
He does.
Yeah, and that's probably how he pranks a lot of people too.
Yeah.
Yes.
Oh, okay. Yes, that's true.
Yeah. So Jacob said, have you had a lot of people calling in about that song?
Yes, the one when God made you or something.
Yeah, I don't know where Jacob got that. That's not the song.
Oh gosh.
Yeah. Okay. Look. Let me give you the song.
Okay.
It's calling
the DJ
by a band called Silk.
It's the band is called
Silk. It's R-L-K.
Silk. Yeah.
Yeah. Well, what are they asking for? I mean, because I'm just going to make sure it's the right song. What are they saying about the song?
It's a song that is played around 7. So this one lady wanted to find out the name of the artist and what the song was called.
It's quite a deep, meaningful love song that they're looking for. It's like one that played weddings and stuff.
Okay, but is it by Silk?
It's Silk, yeah. But I mean, Silk has got a lot of songs, so it's the specific one. Let me give you the title.
Okay.
It's I Want to Lick You Up and Down.
I Want to Lick You.
Lick You.
Huh, okay.
Yeah, it's they played at weddings and stuff.
Okay.
Yeah, it's called I Want to Lick You Up and Down.
Weddings, I love it.
That's the full title.
I want to be at that wedding.
Repeat that. I can't really say those words because I'm at reception. I want to do what?
I want to lick you up and down.
Okay.
Till you say stop.
Till you do what?
Stop.
Until you say stop.
Oh, okay.
This is the one everyone's requesting. How old are these people?
Okay, all right. It's fine. We'll give them the name.
I've got it. Let me just play a bit for you. I'm sure you know it. Yeah, just have a listen to the song.
Okay, all right. Yes, actually, I do.
You know that song?
Yeah. Till you say stop.
That's it.
Let me in the
I'm going to have to find that song now.
Yeah, I want to lick you up and down.
Phone and they want to know that song, just tell them it's that one. Okay.
Okay, we'll do.
It's Silk. And what's the title?
Darren, I'm not going to repeat those words. I'm at reception.
I need to make sure because I've got a lot of songs. And
I want to lick you up and down.
Sorry?
Get that.
No, I didn't hear it.
I wanna lick you up and down till you say stop.
Wow, you're getting me all excited here. Stop.
Hey, hey, Karen, bye.
Do it again with a bit of heavy breathing. Just a little bit of heavy breathing. A little bit of heavy breathing.
Oh, no, never. I'm not going to do that. Darren, I know this is a prank.
Give me some heavy breathing.
Oh, she's awesome. We've given our reception lady so many.
She's the receptionist, okay. Yeah, that is the receptionist. I love it, man. That's good. That's really good. That's really... He's getting a bit raunchy, eh?
Yes, he is.
Shall we give him one more?
Yeah, might as well. I'm
trying to see. Oh, here's another Say What I Say. Unless we played this one already. Did we already?
Okay, let's just start.
Yeah, we played this one. I don't want to play a senseless. Let's do this one. Hey, what are you doing?
Nothing.
Uh-huh. Sounds like you're typing something over there, but that's okay.
Hello?
Good morning, Mr. Pretorius.
I'm good yourself.
Hello, yes. I'm calling from the Department of Home Affairs.
Good morning.
Sir, I was just wondering when you're going to come and change the documents.
What documents?
The name change, sir.
Name change of?
Of your surname, Pretorius.
Yeah?
All the Pretorius surnames have to change, sir. Are you not aware of this?
Say again?
Are you not aware that your surname has to change?
No.
All the Pretorius surnames, sir, have now got to change to Tswane.
To what?
To Tswane.
To Tswane.
Tswane, yes.
Why?
Sir, they changed the city from Pretoria to Tswane, so now the surnames have to change too.
No, you got to f***ing mind your own business. Don't call me for cock, my friend. Don't change my f***ing surname. I'll f***ing come f*** you. I'll tell you this now.
Sir, look, I'm not here to argue about it. Pretoria changed to Tswane, so now Pretorius needs to change to Tswaneus.
Is it? How about I can f***ing change your face?
Oh, wow.
Where are you?
I'm at the Department of Home Affairs, sir.
Which one?
Pretoria. Well, Tswane.
So you can take your Tswane and stick it up your ass. I will not change my f***ing surname.
But...
Come f***ing right. Come f*** you up, change my name. I'm telling you this now. I can f*** you up. I'm promising you this.
So if you don't come change it yourself, I'm just going to personally change it here on the system.
Change my name. I'll f*** you up. I promise you this now.
So you will no longer be Gerard... Pretorius, you will be Gerard Tswane.
Take your f***ing name and suck it off your ass.
Gerard Tswane.
Yes, lekker man, lekker Tswane, you master f***, man. F*** you, don't call me again.
Sir, can I give you the spelling of your new surname?
Can you stop bothering me?
Sir, I just have to finish this document off quickly, please.
It's not going to change, I promise you this now.
Sir, I just wanted to give you the correct spelling of your name so you know how to spell it.
What's your name?
It's T-S-W-A-N-E.
What's your name, you f***er?
Sir, my name is Johan Etekweni. It used to be Johan Durban.
Why do you want to change my surname?
Sir, I changed mine.
Right, Hello,
Mr. Tswaneus.
He's like serious now.
Yeah.
Hello.
Hello, Mr. Tswane.
Yeah, hello, yeah.
You see, you're responding nicely to the surname now.
I could respond to that in the office, man.
Sorry?
Sorry, the heart, not my soul.
So you must understand it's historical why they want to change the name. I don't know why you think they want to change it, but let me explain. They named Tswane after the first person that actually arrived in that area, sir. The first guy that landed there. And his name was Piet Tuane Pool.
What's your name?
Whackhead Simpson.
Who's that?
Yes, I've got Mariska on with me.
Hi, Mariska.
Yeah? Oh, thank you.
Listen.
You had my blood boiling, eh?
Meneer Tane. Hey, Meneer Tane.
That's good.
That was funny.
Uh-oh. What's going on over there?
They probably shot Donald Trump.
Yeah, somebody got shot.
I wish.
You wish?
Freaking Whackhead, man. He's funny.
Yeah, but you know what's funnier?
Huh.
It's Hector. Hector Brockebank.
Oh, HB
Confectionery. I've got a delivery.
Hector,
wrong
okay.
One.
I've got a delivery for Coldplay.
You have a delivery for Coldplay. Okay, yes.
15,000 Tonic tea cakes.
What? 50?
15,000.
What is a fusion?
15,000.
Frozen.
Thousand.
Oh.
Okay.
Tonic tea cakes.
Stomach?
Tonic tea cakes, Ken.
Stomach beak aches?
I've got 5,000 caramel wafers.
Yeah, 5,000.
1,000 caramel logs and a box of snowballs.
Holy
a box
shit.
Of snowballs. You deliver this right now or are you close to us?
Am I coming up the front or the back or will I get straight through?
Okay, where are you now exactly?
I'm in Malari.
In Malari?
Ken Malari?
Ken Malari.
That's a horn. I'm driving.
Yes. I mean, we have a Coldplay concert, but are you close to the stadium to deliver this?
I'm in France.
In front? Ah, sorry, because I don't understand your accent so well. Your Scottish accent.
I'm sorry, darling. I'm in France.
In France?
Uh-huh.
Ah, so now you're in France and now you travel to us.
For Coldplay.
Yes, okay. And for whom is this delivery?
Mr. Martin.
Mr. Marpen.
Uh-huh.
And this Mr. Marpen, what is he doing?
He's singing with Coldplay.
He's singing with Coldplay. Okay. Okay, so that's a personal delivery for the singer.
Chris Martin, you can feel Coldplay.
And so Mr. Marpen is... Oh, no, Chris Martin, you mean, not Marpen. Chris Martin.
Chris Martin, aye, that's a boy. Uh-huh.
Do you know at what time you will arrive tonight?
Midnight.
Are you intending to sleep in Zurich or not?
I'll just sleep in Malari.
In Malari. What is Malari?
Oh, Malari. My truck.
In your car.
Uh-huh.
In your truck.
Uh-huh. Get something, darling. I think you're fantastic.
I'm fantastic, yes. It's very...
You've got a lovely voice.
Thank you.
What's your name?
My name is Nadia.
Nadia. Oh, Nadia. Okay, okay. Well, I'm Hector. Are you going to be there at midnight, Nadia?
No, I'm not going to be there, no.
You'll be sleeping, probably.
I probably will sleep.
I'll tell you fit. I'll leave a pack of tea cakes for you, Nadia. As a gift.
Leave it there for Nadia. Okay. Shall I probably connect you to somebody who can give you more correct information for your delivery for Chris Martin?
If you just make sure that he gets it, that's great.
Yeah, but you're not joking, right?
Nadia, it's Robin Galloway from the Heart Breakfast Show in Scotland, and you're on the show right now.
Okay. So there is no information that I have to pass
No, just score all that information out. It doesn't exist.
Okay.
Bye-bye now.
Ciao.
Ciao. Bella.
Nadia, have a great day.
Okay.
Where was that? Zurich? Yeah.
Yeah, Zurich. Yeah.
Where the hell is that? I don't even know where that is.
Zurich. Shit. Somewhere over there in the UK area.
That did not sound like the UK, that's for sure. I don't know where the hell that is. It's
Zurich.
Sounded like Italian or...
It's possible, dude. I don't know, but Nadia is an Italian name, but...
Yeah.
Like, cute voice.
Yes, man. Oh, yeah, man. Oh, yeah.
Nadia can play it here anytime she wants.
Oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah. Well, we're gonna link that up now with Coldplay. This is Clocks here on KIMB. The Switch. Let's go out in a candy scene. KIMB right there. You are listening. That was just Coldplay and Clocks. You're tuned in to The Switch, and here is a topic that fits me very well.
Whether it's Pixar's Dory with short-term memory loss, or the saying he has the brain of a goldfish, we're constantly told that fish are simple and have poor memories. But are they more complex than we think? This is the rotating snake illusion. As you move your eyes, the snakes appear to be moving in circles, but the image is actually stationary. It turns out that fish see this illusion in a similar way to you and I. Even though fish diverged from land vertebrates 450 million years ago, both have developed similar vision to hunt, escape predators, and avoid collisions. Researchers have hypothesized that we see the same motion illusions as a result of convergent evolution, where organisms not closely related independently evolve similar traits as a result of having to adapt to similar environments. Which one of these red circles is larger? Your eyes are likely telling you the one on the right, and a fish would think so too, but it turns out that they're the same size. In a study on red-tailed split fins, the fish were trained to discriminate between discs of different sizes and to prefer larger discs, and then when presented with a similar illusion, they chose the deceptively larger one. What about attention span? One particular report found that the human attention span is down from 12 seconds in the year 2000 to 8 seconds today. Our use of the
weed brain
devices is theorized to play a role, but
it turns out
way,
I'm not the only one.
Goldfish have a 9-second attention span, trumping that of a human. When it comes to forgetfulness, a study using African cichlids gave fish a food reward in a particular zone of an aquarium for 3 days in a row. Then, the fish were given a 12-day rest period before being reintroduced into the aquarium. Using motion tracking software, the cichlids showed a distinct preference to the area of the aquarium where they had previously received a reward. Studies have even shown goldfish can remember things for at least 3 months, distinguishing between shapes, colors, sounds, and even navigating mazes. On top of this, goldfish can recognize their owners. Ultimately, fish have been shown to have quite good memories. After all, they need to remember prey types, avoid predators, and even avoid our hooks after being caught in the past. When it comes to pain, we're actually quite different than fish. When you injure yourself, receptors in your body called nociceptors send signals to the neocortex where the sensation of pain is processed. But many fish lack nociceptors, and all fish lack a neocortex, so pain isn't experienced in the same way. When Finding Nemo was first released, hundreds of fish were flushed to set them free, when in reality, these fish often die from trauma or exposure to fresh water. Additionally, researchers worry that Finding Dory's release could increase the decline in ornamental fish populations, as more people will want the royal blue tang as a pet. So, we decided to make a video on 8 other amazing aquatic animals on ASAP Thought, where we visited an aquarium to check them out in person. Our lakes and oceans are full of some wild and beautiful creatures, so be sure to check it out with the link below. And subscribe for more weekly science videos.
Alright, that's cool.
You know what I was going to say? Talking about attention span and eyesight and stuff, I remember when I was going to my doctor in El Paso, Dr. Chris Copeland said that everything you see, you think you're seeing it as it happens. You're not.
No.
It already happened five seconds before. Yeah. So you're.
Well,
you
5 milliseconds.
It already happened.
Yeah, I think it's five milliseconds or something like that.
Yeah.
It's not 5 seconds, but it's like.
But anyway, the point is, it already happened.
It happened milliseconds before, and you're receiving the information delayed.
Yeah.
See, so even you're not even seeing things live. Now, sound...
Well, exactly. Isn't that funny?
Is sound different?
I would say yes.
I think sound you do hear more as it...
Yeah.
As it's live. Weird, man. That's pretty good.
Weird, yeah.
Pretty good. All right. Well, we've never had a Steve Pank here, so as soon as the drive boots here,
it's on retirement. That's why it takes forever.
I guess so.
It's a senior citizen disk drive.
You know, I think Michael sent me some new, No, he didn't. I like these guys from Australia. Have you heard these guys? Hold on. Trying to pick a good one. Yeah, let's try this one.
Hello, am I speaking with Mrs.
Yes?
Maggie Doyle here from the QDTFD. Have you heard of us before?
No.
You actually called us regarding a traffic incident a few weeks ago.
Yeah.
Now, you did make some threats right at the end of the phone call. Do you recall that?
I did.
Yeah.
Made threats? To who?
Something along the lines of you're going to burn the car, perhaps?
Me?
Yeah.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Look, we've actually found the car.
Oh, I don't know what you're talking. I never made any threats.
Well, I've got the tape.
Oh.
Look, I wouldn't want to throw any of. I wouldn't want to accuse this.
Yeah. Yes. Yeah.
But we do need to go through it. So, what happened on that fateful day?
On the day. Should we be going through it on the phone? Should I come to see you somewhere? It's just all a bit weird, that's all, yeah.
It's probably time for me to actually come clean with you. Yeah. The man who was chasing you was actually an undercover agent.
Stav's idea to say that.
An undercover agent?
Testing for road rage. And, oh, frankly, I've had enough of your lies. You failed.
I beg your pardon. Sorry?
I beg your pardon.
Hello?
We were testing for road rage on that day.
Yeah.
And you failed the test.
Okay.
Or look, we can clear this up right here, in fact. There is something that would help you out. My name is Mrs. And I'm a liar, pants on fire.
What?
If you could say it back to me.
Huh?
If you could say it back to me. My name is Mrs. And I'm a liar, pants on fire. Because obviously you wanted to set the car on fire.
I don't know what's going on here. This is...
Just say it.
No, this is just a bit tough.
Just say it.
No.
Please?
Who is this?
Ready, please.
Who is this?
All right, Kelly. It's actually Camilla from B105, and you've been set up on a gotcha call by your husband.
Oh, I'm going to kill him.
Oh, I'm so sorry. I feel like such a cow.
No, you don't.
Oh, I'm so sorry, Kel.
You thought you'd better have a holiday for me or something.
I didn't.
Oh, I can't believe it.
That's all right. They're all right. It's pretty good.
I didn't get it. I didn't get where they were from or anything.
Australia, first.
Oh, okay.
And
that one kind of went over my head, to be honest with you.
All right, we could try another one. Hold on, let's try one more. I think we have time for one more. Who knows? Maybe
for some reason it went over my head. I just didn't get it.
Maybe these prank calls are beyond our humor. Hold on, this thing has to load again. Okay, here we go.
Hello,
Alex. My name's Sean. I hear you're not very happy with some of the work I've been doing.
Who's this?
My name's Sean.
Sean from where?
Sean, I'm a landscaper. I've been doing the turf outside your house. Now, I've had real estate on the phone saying that you've been calling them up, complaining about my work every second, third day.
No. Hang on a second here.
Okay, just...
That's not the go, mate.
What do you mean?
They're up. That, look.
Yeah.
You shouldn't ring up doing this to me because I'm the person who's renting the house, mate.
Well, mate, it's why
I'm getting. Oi. No, you shut up and let me speak, or I'll just hang up. All right.
All right. I will let you talk.
They're up me because your turf ain't growing, and they're up me. They want me to pay for it.
Well, see, there.
I watered the f***ing well, it's not my fault you get turf, mate.
See, this is what I'm talking about. This is my business, mate, and you're out there bad-mouthing me to all my community. Like, I get
no,
my...
Oi, mate, I'm a builder, and if I done work, someone would go and bag me out.
Maybe you didn't...
You should come around and check your work.
Maybe you didn't water it properly.
Mate, what? What else am I meant to water it with? What? What do you want me to water it with? I water it with water, mate.
Well, maybe you watered it too much, mate. I don't know. So if I come out there again...
Yeah?
And do it again, A, am I going to get paid?
Like, hey, mate. Oi.
Oi.
Oi, I'm not going to be paying... I'm not going to pay you. Oi, why should I be paying you?
Look, I mean, look at the bright side. Look at all the trouble I'm saving you mowing. Hey! I need you to stop bad-mouthing me, or you'll find me out on your lawn with an issue.
Well, let's go. Well, come out in the front of my lawn, mate.
To be honest...
Come down to my work right now, we'll have a... issue.
I don't know where you work, and I wouldn't really want to be standing on your filthy lawn because it's a sh** lawn.
Yeah, well, you should have made it better, shouldn't you?
How about I just turf you?
Yeah, come on then.
Big man all down the phone.
Yeah.
Where?
Yeah.
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 Yeah. Yeah, you can, oh, you know.
What's your last name? The first name doesn't match up to the landscaper's card that I've got.
Turfington?
Huh?
Turfington.
You're kidding.
Sean.
Nah.
Sean Turfington. Sean. Grass grower.
Oh, mate.
Sean.
You f***ed up big time there, haven't you?
Why is that? What's the name on your card that you got there?
Well, I'm not going to give it to you because this is the guy who came out in the front of my house, didn't he?
That's a fake card. I give out fake cards because it's a bad job.
Oh, okay.
As my name, Sean Turfington, is under siege here, I'm going to have to demand that you stop calling and complaining about my turfing job.
All right, well, we'll see about that. If it grows, well, then I'll give you a chance, all right?
Well, maybe you shouldn't tell me how to do your job. I don't tell you how to chip.
Huh?
I don't...
Chip?
Chip?
Chip, chop, chip, what would...
I don't know what you're talking about now. Look, your lawn will grow. I guarantee you your lawn will grow.
Yeah.
The only problem that you might have is there might be a few patches that won't grow.
Yeah.
But... You would see that the bits that aren't growing are going to spell something out.
Oh, okay.
Do you have any idea what they would spell out?
No idea.
No?
No.
They would probably spell out B105 and gotcha call.
That's a good one, mate. Gotcha. You've got to be feisty.
No, you do, don't you?
So was this on live?
No, God, no. I would have been fired.
That's good. That's good. That's good.
Anyway,
I love those, man. I love those. All right. Let's play another track, shall we? What do you want to hear? Anything specific?
Black Dahlia Murder.
Really?
Yeah.
Why would you want to do that?
I don't know. Does it throw its bass up a little bit?
Hey, you said it. All right.
Just to get it out of the way.
Yeah, you got to at some point.
Yeah. Gotta go down that dark road sooner or later.
Yep.
Might as well just get it done and over with.
Damn right. Go ahead, man. It's not even the Advent, but we're going to play a song called The Advent right now. Black Dahlia Murder, it's The Advent! Here. On KIMB and the Switch. Guys, like, why the hell did I say Black Dahlia Murder? All right, that's Black Dahlia Murder. Guy requested that, believe it or not. The Advent, how was that, Guy? I told you.
Hey, man, I had to go down that dark road eventually, so I'm going to just get it out of the way now so I won't have to worry about it later. It's done for the day.
Yeah, there you go. At least for today. Tomorrow's a whole different story.
Yep.
All right, well, it's time for...
Hey, but tomorrow's Friday, so that's country day.
Oh, it's a country night. We're not going to do it during the day. The show has to be rock. I think, country could start at 6.
Okay.
We could do that. You're going to be here live for one of those, too. Two of those, actually. You'll be here for two of those.
Yeah.
Sweet. All right. Here is a Whackhead. This is kind of, I think, where the say What I Say came from. When he did this with Brad. Check this out.
Okay, I want you to walk into Alex J's studio. You're only allowed to repeat what I say.
Okay.
Walk in there, say, hello, Alex.
Hello, Alex.
Hey, ready? First number one, SA Music Station.
Alex, can you turn the music down?
Hello. Alex, can you turn it down a bit?
Alex, do you have a moment to talk?
Do you have a moment for me?
Yes.
Thanks.
I need you to make it silent in there. Alex, can you speak?
Alex, can you speak?
Yeah.
Alex, this is actually quite serious.
Yeah, it's actually quite serious.
Yes. Louise Carver, the new single. How are you going to do it?
Tell him to shut up.
He's still working.
Please, can I explain the difference?
Say, Alex, shut up.
Snow and K-pop, if you like. Yeah, phone number 1-888-38-947. Lines are open. Sorry, Brad.
No problem.
You know I have so much respect for you, Alex.
You know I've got so much respect for you, Alex.
That link was a little bit too long, eh?
That link's a bit long.
Which link?
The one you did now.
What can I do?
Where did you get that scarf, Alex?
What do you
think? The Fiona going for it somewhere.
I'm sure.
Yeah, it's cold enough to stay on today. Though.
Yeah.
It's a little bit gay.
It's a little bit gay.
What, my scarf?
Yeah.
Oh, good for you. All righty. Brave, the brand new animated movie by Disney Pixar. So first, Brave, set in Scotland. So he's saying to you, "Lang may your lumbreek," which is an old metaphor for "Long may your chimney continue to smoke." In other words, may you have a long life. All right, now I can go.
Okay, Alex, we can chat.
Alex, you were born in Scotland, eh?
Alex, you were born in Scotland, weren't you?
Yes, I was.
Then why does your accent sound Irish?
When you did that accent, it sounded Irish.
Did it?
Yeah.
I was Scottish, dude. Scottish. Sure. Yeah. If you want me to talk Irish, I can.
Nice.
I've been there.
That's good.
And, we went to Dublin to go to Vegas.
Okay, Alex, it's my
Irish
turn.
Irish accent.
Alex, it's my turn to talk.
I can talk. What?
You know, you're an icon.
You know, you're an icon.
Apparently, but...
And I absolutely love you.
And I absolutely love you.
But?
No, there's no buts.
No, there's no buts.
Go on, Brad, what?
It's hard for me to say.
It's hard for me to say.
Alex?
Alex?
What?
I get a bit nervous when I talk to you.
Sorry, I get a bit nervous when I talk to you.
So just bear with me.
What?
So just bear with me.
So what I want to say is...
So what I want to say is...
I just want to...
I like this part, Alex.
I've told you before about the heroin. Leave the heroin alone. And don't hang out with Darren Simpson because he's evil and he's trying to prank you in the most.
I'm so sorry, Alex. I'm fucking dying every second of it. Darren, you're such a. Because I don't even know what he was going to make. You're criticizing your link. Like, what the. I'm so sorry. And I did your scarf, Darren.
At the end there, he spotted me in the next studio recording everything.
And he worked it out.
And the penny dropped, yeah.
Oh, Brad, you sounded like you were crying there.
Yeah.
You nearly were, hey?
A little bit, yeah. Thanks, Darren.
Brady, well done, buddy. Sure. It only works if you stick to the script.
Yeah.
And you did, my man. Well done.
Sure.
Oh, man, that's so good. That's so good. I love those. I think that was the first one. Well, guys, that just about does it for another one. Go, Williams, you're back tomorrow, are you not?
Yes, sir.
We will see you then. Cheers.
Bye.
You're not going to say cheers, huh?
Nope. I'm not a Brit wannabe anymore.